This is Gay Science. In today's episode, what makes someone gay? Several years ago, a class finished at the Chromatica Institute's Learning Gay Source Center, and a young gifted twunk janitor was cleaning the classroom and noticed on the blackboard a correlation between certain properties and homosexuality. There were specific elements that gay people were drawn to. He brought his discovery to the Dean of Daddy Studies, and together they drafted up a table. And it was named the Periodic Table of Homosexual Elements. The table comprised of 56 elements of periodic law in 8 homoatomic categories. By themselves, they may seem ordinary, but together, they make up what it means to be gay. Basic metals are core elements, the building blocks of homosexuality. Like operating on an accelerated schedule, WIG, and knowing that your nudes are probably out there. Outer elements affect behavior and interactions, like doing unnecessary things in groups, a long, fat, thick vibrato, going out, but also staying in, and arching their back out no matter where they are. Like, this is an airport. Earth metals are found in homosexual environments. Polyatomic saboteurs are internal demons that regularly inflict the gaze. Like being late to everything, even though they were doing nothing. And hemorrhoids. Les alloids are elements popularized by lesbians that all queer people now enjoy. It was lesbians who invented small batches. Unknown chemical properties are miscellaneous gay obsessions, like English class, survival movies, adopting a dog that's also purebred, and shaming people on the internet by replacing vowels with asterisks. Allycalines are elements that aren't gay themselves, but are definitely allies. Like your local pharmacist. And lastly, gay people don't have a god. They have pop stars. The noble divas are singers that gays have chosen as their champions.